Hey, what is up, mortals? It's JC here. And before we get in today's video, there's something I'd like to say. I'd like to let you all know that we have a merch store. Some of the items in it are only available for a limited amount of time. So if you're interested, go into the description and check it out. Each purchase helps us make more content. Now, with that out of the way, let's get into the video. The Sage of Six Paths, also known by his other alias, the Father of All Shinobi, is a character who has been subtly mentioned in the story ever since Jiraiya found out about Nagato's eyes. His real name is Hagoromo Otsutsuki, and today we'll be diving into everything we can about this powerful and mysterious being. The Sage was born alongside Hamura, his younger twin brother. His mother, Kaguya, is an Otsutsuki princess, who ate the forbidden chakra fruit of the god tree. Just so you guys know, we'll be discussing more on Kaguya in further detail in a later video. The god tree appears once every 1,000 years, and with it comes an immense source of chakra. She used the power she gained from the god tree to put an end to the constant wars that occurred in that era. Hagoromo was born with the same chakra reserves and abilities to manipulate the same powerful chakra as his mother. Angered by the fact that her chakra has spread to others, Kaguya merged with the god tree, turning into the Ten Tails, which attempted to reclaim her chakra. The Ten Tails would ravage the lands across the shinobi world. Subsequently, Hagoromo and his brother, Hamura, had to deal with their mother, eventually coming out victorious in their self-defense. After the Ten Tails' defeat, Hagoromo sealed the beast within himself, making him the Ten Tails' first Jinchuriki. Learning his mother's techniques, Hagoromo was able to free the inhabitants of the world from Kaguya's infinite Tsukiyomi. He then made his alias the Sage of Six Paths after entering priesthood. Traveling across the world, Hagoromo would share chakra with everyone else. As this occurred, he would spread his ideals and religion of Ninshu in the process. His great deeds with his desire to bring peace to the war-corrupted world made him known as the savior of this world. Hagoromo's wish is to build a foundation of peace across the world, but he knew this achievement would never come true in his lifetime. He chose to entrust his legacy to his two sons, teaching them Ninshu in the process. Indra, the older son, was a genuine prodigy, quickly beginning to take pride in his prowess. However, Asura was the exact opposite of his brother. Showing no special abilities or natural talent, through this struggle, he pushed on past his limitations, growing stronger and more mature, making friends with others along the way. Hagoromo acknowledged Asura's chosen path, agreeing that cooperation between others was the valid key to peace. Even though the sage has proven great feats, there was also this omnipresent concern over Hagoromo himself. The concern deprived of the fact that Hagoromo was still the Jinchuriki of the Ten Tails. The reason this became a concern was because of Hagoromo. Even if he was seemingly all-powerful, he still was not immortal. Meaning, at some point, Hagoromo would still pass away naturally. If this happened, there was this theory that the Ten Tails would once again release itself from Hagoromo's corpse. Asura would then come up with an idea to split the Ten Tails into 9 separate entities, making them all easier to manage within this fragile world. Hagoromo, being left incapacitated for several months, was kept alive by the powerful life force of the Ten Tails husk. Sometime after the creation of the tailed beasts, Hagoromo told them that they are all still linked to one another despite being apart from each other. Hagoromo told them that they would eventually become one again, and that one shall appear at that time to show them the proper way. In the anime, it showed that just before his death, the sage and his followers built temples in the 9 regions of the world. Hagoromo set this up so that way the tailed beasts had a place to live and be protected. Hagoromo would then seal the husk of the Ten Tails within the moon. Due to Hagoromo's acknowledgement of both his sons as they were growing up, they both began to have conflicting paths. Indra, the older son, found that absolute domination was the only way for peace. If everyone lived under the rule of one mind, everyone would think the same. Well, Asura's belief lies within friendship, as well as cooperation being the key to peace. To build a society through others, building everyone else up, exchanging support amongst each other. Just before the sage's death, he chose Asura to become his successor. Indra disagreed, overcome by bitterness and envy, allowing Black Zetsu, which is a manifestation of Kaguya's will, to manipulate him. The events that occurred leads to the brothers' infamous ongoing battle, ultimately starting a war between them that would continue throughout their descendants. Worried that Indra or one of his reincarnations would eventually attempt at taking Asura's power for themselves, this tablet details his history and hoping this would help them reconsider. To make sure this info was exclusive to Indra and his reincarnations, only those who possess the Rinnegan will be able to decipher the contents of the tablet. However, unknown to the sage, Black Zetsu altered the contents of the tablet. Instead, it would resurrect Kaguya and initiate the infinite Tsukuyomi. Hagoromo's death did not stop the sage from reappearing. His chakra and consciousness remained and traversed the world through his son's reincarnations. Hagoromo was a tall, pale man who had deep wrinkles and a strong jawline, even for his elderly age. He had pale brown hair, a braided lock hanging from his left ear. His facial hair is that of a goatee, which was short when he was younger and later grew down to his waist at an old age. Hagoromo had a pair of horns extending from either side of his forehead. He also had a red Rinnegan marking embedded on his forehead, referred to as his third eye. Hagoromo also wore a white kimono that had a pattern of six black magatamas around the collar, beneath which he wore a necklace that also has six black magatamas. The back of the kimono laid a marking that resembles a massive black Rinnegan, as well as a pattern of nine magatamas arranged in three rows of three beneath it. Hagoromo sought peace by spreading his wisdom across the world. He was wise, being able to bring about a significant change to the world by spreading his knowledge of chakra and his religion, Ninshu. He also cared for the tailed beasts when they were still with him, giving each a name as a sign of their individuality, telling them that no matter how far apart they grew, they would always be together, and someday follow down the right path. The tailed beasts showed respect for the sage. The way they would act suggested that the beasts might even view him as a father figure. His compassion for peace was great, even after learning of his mother's immoral actions, which included the death of Hagoromo's crush, Hayori. He never succumbed to his griefs, despite awakening his Sharingan. He would hope to settle the matter with words, rather than violence. Even more, despite rebelling against his mother, he still loved and respected her, continually referring to her as mother, even when acknowledging her primal evil. After trying to undo the rift he created between his sons, as well as their reincarnations, the sage would admit that he was unable to repair the damage caused by him. As such, he put his trust into Naruto at the end of the Fourth Great Ninja War. Hagoromo is globally known to be the most influential figure in history, second only to his mother. He defeated the Ten Tails and would steal away his mother alongside his brainwashed brother. Hagoromo's might alone ultimately made him revered as a god. He obtained a great group of followers from his journey of teachings. His power even transcends time itself, being able to observe the world and meet with people long after his death. Hagoromo wielded tools which became known as the treasure tools of the Sage of Six Paths. Each tool possesses a unique and powerful ability. The five treasures are the Basho-sen, Benihisago, Konkinjo, Shichiseken, and the Kohaku no Johe. By combining the Benihisago, Konkinjo, and Shichiseken, Hagoromo was able to capture the souls of his victims, drawing them into the gourd to seal their souls away. With the Basho-sen, he was able to generate any of the five chakra natures. The Gohaku no Johei allowed him to seal anyone without the complicated use of the Benihisago. All five tools require enormous amounts of chakra to use, which can quickly kill an average person through chakra exhaust. Though, due to Hagoromo's massive chakra reserves, he does not suffer from this drawback. The impossibility of overestimating Hagoromo's effect on the ninja world's development is not fathomable. He was the first true ninja, creating the ninja world of the series Naruto. As his disciples grew continuously in number, it would inevitably become the creation of the ninja clans. Despite his efforts to use ninshu to promote peace, the populace would begin to use chakra as a means to gain strength over others. They weaponized ninshu, deviating away from the teachings of the sage, ultimately forming ninjutsu. As time continued, Hagoromo faded into just a legend, his bloodline divided amongst the reincarnation of his sons. This would form the Senju clan, the Uzumaki clan, and the Uchiha clan. Later on, Madara Uchiha acquired the cells of Hashirama Senju, mending it into his body. Madara successfully fused the chakras of the sage's sons, recreating Hagoromo's chakra. Though, nothing happened initially after the cells merged inside of Madara. As he got closer to the end of his life, the dojutsu would finally awaken. He managed to undo Hagoromo's seal on the Ten Tails by summoning it from the moon. As a result, Madara formed the Eye of the Moon plan to become the Ten Tails' next Jinchuriki. Nagato was a member of the Senju and Uzumaki clans, and a wielder of the Rinnegan. These properties of Nagato led him to being the perfect host for the dojutsu. However, Nagato himself noted that his power would have been inadequate in comparison to the sage. Others, including Kakashi Hatake and Onoki, noted the sage was just a myth, and the Rinnegan was viewed merely as a mutation. Centuries after Hagoromo died, his prophecy about the world-changing boy who would unite the tailed beasts came true. The tailed beasts would all agree that this person was Naruto Uzumaki. The sage possesses every single one of the chakra natures, including fire release, wind release, lightning release, earth release, water release, yang release, and yin-yang release. On top of this, he's also in possession of a couple of Kakegenkais, these being the Sharingan, as well as the Mangekyo Sharingan. Later in his lifetime, Hagoromo would gain a Kakemura. This would be the Rinnegan. Overall, the Sage of Six Paths was an all-powerful being, who luckily was also very kind and selfless. Unlike his mother and his son Indra, he never took his power for granted, and he never would use any pride to boast his power. This man was kind and is worthy of all of the aliases the sage has gained. Everyone in the Naruto universe must have come off lucky to have someone as powerful as Hagoromo to be as kind as he was, because if he was more like his mother, it would have been utterly disastrous for the rest of the series. With that, we went over all the juicy details we could find regarding the Sage of Six Paths. Sorry if we missed anything on a smaller scale. This video is just for those who wish to know many of his feats throughout the series. Thank you all for watching the video to the end. Now, there are a few more things I'd like to go over before the video ends. Firstly, I'd like to remind you all that we have a merch store. Some of the items in it are only available for a limited amount of time. So, if you're interested, go into the description and check it out. Each purchase helps us make more content. Secondly, I'd like to thank our Patreon supporters for helping fund these videos. Lastly, on behalf of We the Celestials, I'd like to thank the writer for this video, as well as the editor for this video. Their details will be in the description. If you're a voice actor, editor, or writer, or you're interested in becoming one of those, go to the Discord that is in the description of this video and hit up the head of one of those departments. We are always looking for new members to join us. That's it from us for today's video, so thank you all for watching, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you're interested, and hit that like button if you liked the video. Until next time, peace out, mortals. Have an amazing day. Eyes in the sky, gazing far into the night, I raise my hand.
shine to the fire, but it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through. If you believe.